working for you.
We are on top of flooding in the Coastal Empire and Lowcountry tonight. Parts of Chatham County reporting nearly 7 inches of rain tonight as it continues to come down outside.
And here you can see video taken earlier. Flooding in Garden City, Dean Forest Road near Highway 80 was shut down for a time, but it has since reopened. Good evening to you. I'm Jennifer Andrews.
And I'm Kevin Holmes. We've been tracking the heavy rainfall as it's pounded our area for hours now. Let's get right to Storm Tracker Chief Meteorologist Jeff Kurt to see when we'll be in the clear. Jeff?
Well, I'll tell you what, the heavy rains have certainly subsided, but that was a lot of rain that came down in a short period of time, especially in northwest Chatham County, as you saw in that video there in Garden City.
Got hammered.
They did. It really did. As we take a look at your live radar, though, we just have some areas of light rain that are still out there, and they'll continue to diminish here as we head on, finish out the evening and go past midnight, and then we'll have lingering clouds after that. Let's check out rain totals out there today. I want to show you a Doppler estimate here, and that the bullseye was clearly in northwest Chatham County here. Here's downtown Savannah. We had over an inch of rain there. We certainly had our share of heavy rain, but it got worse as we head up towards Garden City and Port Wentworth, and Doppler radar estimating almost 7 inches of rain in this orange spot right there. That's a Doppler estimate. That's likely underdone in these situations. So we're probably talking about 8 inches of rain. Out of the airport, we had over 6.5 inches of rain, and we actually set a record for the most rain on a June day of all time. So it was quite a doozy of a downpour out there this afternoon. Obviously, many of you know that you live out there in northwest Chatham. And all the rain come to an end here. We got lingering clouds, but light rain now still occurring across portions of the Lowcountry. Between Bluffton, Hilton Head, and Beaufort, we have light rain, but we don't have anything heavy enough to cause any additional flooding. Temperatures brought down by all that rain today, and we're looking at them numbers across the area in the low to mid 70s. And that's about where we're going to stay as we head through the rest of the night, as clouds will linger. So we'll be mostly cloudy and temperatures staying about where they are right now. I'll have your numbers and your forecast for wet weather coming up for the rest of the week, and we'll look all the way ahead to the weekend coming up in just a bit.
Thank you, Jeff. Meantime, some roads in Port Wentworth, they were hit hard tonight by floodwaters as well. Emergency crews responded to houses on Armadale Road and surrounding streets. Check out the scene there as the ground just could not contain the quick falling rain. We had several calls into our newsroom of people's property flooding. And with flooding still in effect, the National Weather Service has these tips for anyone caught in a flash flood. When a flash flood warning is issued for your area, act quickly to save yourself. You may only have seconds, and don't try crossing a stream if the water is above your knees. Also, if you're driving, don't cross moving water. It can take only 6 inches to sweep your vehicle off the road. And if your vehicle does get stuck, get out and seek higher ground.
And we are working for you to help you stay aware. You can keep up with the weather from the palm of your hand by downloading our app to your smartphone. That way you can pull up the forecast before heading out the door. New at 11, a woman is recovering at an area hospital after a shooting, the accused gunman behind bars. This happened in Jasper County near Fordsville Road. According to the Jasper County Sheriff, a woman was shot several times during a domestic dispute. She did survive. Again, investigators telling us tonight this resulted from a domestic situation. More than 70 people have been arrested in a prostitution sting in Atlanta, including several people from our area. FBI agents teamed up with law enforcement across the state, including Savannah and Effingham counties, to rescue nearly a dozen children from sex trafficking. Investigators say the suspects were from as far away as New York and Missouri. Those suspects faced several charges, including pimping, prostitution, and solicitation. Here's a look at those arrested locally from Beaufort, South Carolina. 28-year-old Timothy Kimball, he's charged with enticing the child for indecent purposes. 34-year-old Gerald Hammond of Ridgeland, charged with the same offense. And four suspects arrested are from Hinesville. 29-year-old Antonio Bowman, charged with pimping. 29-year-old LaShonda Collins, 24-year-old Robin Hudson, and 21-year-old Ashley Cole have all been charged with prostitution.
Well, a dangerous night on the roads as we are covering several wrecks. First, a pedestrian was